With Task Manager, you can centrally manage a large set of tasks for business process, such as planning, provide visibility and automation of tasks, as well as record activities related to those tasks. With Task Manager scalability, you can execute hundreds of tasks all at the same time. Task Manager is available in cloud EPM planning, tax reporting, and financial consolidation and close. During the planning application creation process, service administrators can enable EPM Task Manager instead of task lists. Let's go over common terms used in Task Manager. Tasks are a unit of action in the business process. They represent the lowest level of activity tracking that can be reported on within a business process. Service administrators empower users to find tasks and assign users to tasks. Users can read task instructions, answer questions, submit, reassign, approve, and reject tasks, and access tasks from email notifications or by logging onto the application. Schedules define the chronologically ordered set of tasks that must be executed for a specific business process. This could be your budget development, or a planned forecast or budget revision. Templates are the blueprints of repeatable tasks. They define all interactions required of the tasks and can be leveraged to create multiple schedules that can be executed based on a calendar frequency, such as monthly or quarterly. Alerts are notifications from users on issues that they encounter during the process. These issues can either be hardware or software. After your planning application is set up, and before diving into task definition, you may need to set these up based on your company requirements. These settings may be modified anytime after setting them up. If you plan on using holiday rules, set up your organizational units. Organizational units are also used for filtering and reporting. Set up global integration tokens if you plan to use parameterized URLs. Configure URLs from static parameters in your application, attributes of type, text, and list, as well as native attributes assigned to tasks, templates, and schedules. Configure system settings such as comments and task deletions, task display in the worklist and welcome panel, email notifications, reassignment request approval, conditions and permission to reopen tasks, and tasks in Smart View. Set task governors to determine the maximum values for the number of items displayed in a list, maximum approver levels, and maximum file upload size. When you're ready to define tasks, start with creating task types to identify and categorize tasks that are commonly used in your business process. Basic and parent tasks are predefined task types included in Task Manager. You can add more task types later as you create more tasks. Then, create task templates for repeatable tasks. Task templates are also used as a basis for creating schedules. Templates do not execute. Schedules define the order of which tasks are executed and is the application of a template into the calendar. When you add tasks to templates, you set a start date and time. End user tasks also have an end date and time when added to a template. The dates are based on template days and not on calendar dates. When you add tasks to a schedule, you select calendar dates for the start and end dates. Tasks are classified into two execution types. Manual tasks require users to complete the task and verify that the task was completed. Automated tasks require no user interaction and are based on their schedule. You can create a schedule that includes a combination of manual end-user tasks and automated tasks to help streamline your planning process. For example, you can kick off a job that loads incremental data after completing a task that involves data entry on a form. Related videos are listed in the description. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.